and we were doing that. What are you learning about the background of the suspect?
Don, a little bit more about the extensive planning that may have gone into this attack by this suspect. CNN has obtained a receipt of tactical gear that James Holmes bought online back on July 2nd. The tactical gear, which matches the description of some of the witnesses who describe what he was wearing, an urban assault vest, a triple pistol magazine, an M16 magazine pouch, and a knife, a large knife, all of them colored in black. And we do have that receipt. We're trying to get that accessible, but it was shipped to his home that the police are now at right now. But it shows that he's been planning this for a while.
With full protective gear, as we heard the witnesses say, they couldn't even make out what he looked like. All they could see was just how tall he was and what his stature. They didn't know what race he was. Nothing, because he was fully covered, and he's also covering. He covered key parts of his body, groin area, and also his neck area as well.
Right. Now, there's no gas mask on this, no headgear on this itemized list. It was for $306.79. But the fact that it was all ordered and colored in black seems to indicate that he was putting together some kind of outfit that would match other things that he might have on his body.
And, Drew, you're working on more information on the receipt, and I'm sure if we have that receipt, but you have obtained that receipt, and we're getting it into the
system
now.
And obtain the itemized pictures, and we'll have that through the night, but we just want to deliver that information as we get it in this ongoing investigation.
Drew Griffin, stand by. Drew, with more on the suspect's background. I want to go now to New York and to our Miguel Marquez to learn more about this suspect as well. Miguel, this investigation is not just here in Colorado. It's really stretching across the country. This suspect who according to law enforcement, said he was a joker and even colored his hair red. What are you learning?
Yeah, agents for the FBI, the ATF, and law enforcement across the country want to know exactly who this guy is. He was from San Diego, California. He went to a decent high school there. By all accounts, he was sort of a person who didn't raise much suspicion among anyone. Agents in San Francisco, in San Diego, there are several of them, numerous agents, looking into his background, interviewing family, interviewing friends, going through any computers that he may have accessed. He also went to school in Riverside, California, and law enforcement there are doing the same, talking to the school officials and any friends that he may have there. One interesting note, a pawn shop in San Diego in the last few months, a pawn broker said that they had a conversation with Mr. Holmes and that he was asking about guns. He was asking about guns that he might use to protect him in his home, and they recommended several of the guns that he used that night. He did not purchase them there, he said. It would be illegal to purchase guns in California if you were a Colorado resident, but it's not very clear when exactly he went to California. It sounds like it was very, very recently or fairly recently that he did go to California. They recommended both the Glock and the shotgun to him, both weapons that were on him in that theater. So it is clear that this guy was thinking about this for quite some time. One other interesting note is that when his mother was woken up this morning by another news agency and asked about him and whether or not he was her son, she responded, "Yep, you have the right person. You have the right guy." It's clear that this family probably knew something was amiss with James Holmes. Done.